So we have a trailer that's been sitting here for, I want to say, a couple of years. I had it in the corner right over there, sitting. So, you know, it has a lot of rust on it. And since we have the additional vehicle, we're going to go ahead and do a light setup, something real easy with either a 36 or 42 as a main mower, and then a 21 inch for the back gates. I'm still trying to work out the kinks on exactly what I want to do with this specific trailer, but it is going out there. And what it is a 5x8 single axle trailer, and we did a little bit of modifications on it as far as putting the basket in the front. It has locks, so you know, it works pretty well. Nothing too high speed, but you know, it does what it's supposed to do.
We have the blower rack right here, and we modified and made this one. It's rusty, but it works. I'm about to spray paint it, and we sanded, well, I sanded this all over. In the gate, let me show you the gate. It has our blades of grass, complete property ground maintenance, telephone number, license insured, and it is also rusty. I'm about to hit it real quick. The racks are made, a friend of mine made the racks, and basically what it is, it's I'm gonna put some sort of rubber, probably get a hose and cut it in half and glue it here so it'll hold the string equipment or whatever handheld I want to put in here, and it won't rip it up. And we're gonna spray paint this part and probably put something here to kind of hold it, some rubber gasket or something like that. And as you can tell how old it is, it's been sitting here for years. Look at that, all that green moss. But doesn't matter, all I want it for is to hook it up to the trailer. I'm gonna spray paint it, and I'm using some Rust-Oleum.
Now the goal, today's goal, is to just get it to look good. I'm not going into the specific as far as the detailing, and you know, I should have took it to a shop, or I, you know, use something else. That's okay, guys. That's not what I'm trying to accomplish here. I'm trying to make it look good, it's functionable, and I'm gonna use what I have. I'm not gonna go out there and buy new racks or anything like that. It's It works. We have a lock right here. Put all your stuff in there, put a lock. So I gotta go out there and buy some, probably buy some locks for it.
Also have these metal signs that I'm gonna put right here so we can see it. I'm gonna attach those right there.
Again, guys, nothing too fancy. I just want to make sure that it works, it looks good. And I'll tell you the story of how I got this trailer. I actually started my business in 2009, and I had a customer that was deploying overseas. And he said, listen, I'll pay you for the whole season. If you give me a good price, give him a good price. He paid me, I think he paid me like $600-$700. I took the money and I went and bought this trailer. And he's been just sitting there for the longest after I started buying my enclosed trailers and all of that. Okay, enough about the story on the trailer. Let's go ahead and spray paint.
right, this is what it's starting to look so far. This is only two cans. Two can of red paint. Not bad, not bad, not bad. Oh, these are roof tiles. Shingles for the roof. I just put them there. No specific reason. I just put them there. All right, guys, this is what it looks like. Hold on, let me close this up. Like, and here's a sign. Now these are old signs. If I had a chance to do it all over again, it would basically just have the logo and the telephone number. That's it. But again, this sign is I had this sign since years. All right, so there it is, the trailer. Not bad, huh? Once again, 5x8, single axle. Everything is custom. So don't ask in the comments, where did I get the rack from? Where did I get the blower rack from? Everything has been made. All right, guys. Thanks for taking the time to watch my videos, guys. See you on the next one. Pop Smoke.